My name is Robb Diehl. I'm a research ecologist at the Northern Rocky Mountain Science Center in Bozeman, Montana. What's new or innovative about what I do? I use a lot of remote sensing technology. These are technologies that advance along with the electronics industry frequently, and so we're always seeing updates in that regard. We apply those technologies to monitoring principally the movements of flying animals, bats, birds, sometimes insects. We use radars, we use thermal cameras, we use radio telemetry, and other kinds of remote sensing, again, mostly to look at movements of animals. My project is innovative in part because we're taking instrumentation that has been designed with a weather-related meteorological application in mind and applying it to the study of animal movement. And it's not often that biologists have the opportunity to take advantage of such large embedded infrastructure to do their biological work. And so that's just one technical aspect of why it's innovative. Well, principal challenges there's always a funding challenge. You know, we're always struggling to find ways to find people and convince people to support our work. And when it comes to technical challenges, especially when one is using automation as we do frequently, you gather a lot of information on noise, non-target information. And so we spend time writing software or engage in other activities that are intended to improve the data quality after it's already been collected. And that's an ongoing concern. Success for this project would come in a variety of forms. One, in relation to using weather radars to track the movements of flying animals, to develop the technology to be able to mine that information from archives that already exist. And so the data's out there. It's waiting for us to get a hold of it. That would be the first part of the success. The second part of the success would come in our ability to apply those algorithms to answer some of the important questions of how flying animals influence the day-to-day lives of people, either in relation to flight safety or informing hunters when the waterfowl movements are coming through. Why am I passionate? I love computing and I love the natural world, which is a strange marriage. And that dates back even to my days entering graduate school. I was looking for people to work with that had a lot of knowledge about computers and programming and a lot of knowledge about ecology. And back then, that was an uncommon marriage. Today it's pretty common because technology drives a lot of what we do. So I like both the technological aspect and the biological aspects of what I do. I started bird watching when I was 9 years old. And so that's fallen out of favor a little bit because I don't have so much time to do that anymore. But that's a testament to how far back my interest in the natural world goes.